मूविंग अहेड विद डिविजिबिलिटी बाय सिक्स, यू सी एनी नंबर इट्स फैक्टर विल बी सिक्स व्हेन यू नो व्हेन दैट नंबर हैज टू एंड थ्री ऑलरेडी एज वन ऑफ द फैक्टर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल we have to say that write the factors of 156. So if this 156 has 2 also it's one of the factor and 3 also it's one of the factor, that time 6 itself will be known as it's one of the factor. Okay, so the rule for 6 is the number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by both 2 and 3. Okay, if the number has 2 and 3 already as the factor, then 6 itself will be considered as it's one of the factor. Just keep this thing in your mind. You can see here in this number 6 is there, right? So 6 is the even number. When in ones place it is even number, that time 2 is its factor. And when we will do the sum of its digit, 5 plus 1 6 and 6 plus 6 is 12. So 12 is also coming in the table of 3. So 3 is also the factor. So this number has 2 and 3 both as its factor. So when a number has 2 and 3 both as its factor, then we will write 6 also as its factor. Got it clear, no? One more example I'll give you. Suppose this is 500. This number has even number in its ones place. So 2 will be its factor for sure, but when you will add the digits you will get 5. Is 5 coming in the table of 3? So 3 is not its factor, it has only 2 as its factor. So when it has any 1 among 2 and 3, that time we will not say 6 as its factor. Okay, any 1 should not be there. Like among 2 and 3, only 2 is there, so then also 6 is the factor, or only 3 is there, then also 6 is the factor. No, it should have both the number 2 and 3 as its factor, then only 6 will be its one of the factor. Clear rule for 6? Okay, now we will come to divisibility by 8. You see, the rule I told you for 4, if its last 2 digits are 0, or when you divide without remainder that time, same rule is for 8 also. Same rule is for 8 also. Only the difference is in 4, I told you for last 2 digits. In 8, there is last 3 digits. Okay, if in any number, its last 3 digits are 0. Any number, its last 3 digits are 0. And its last 3 digit when you divide with 8, you get no remainder, that time 8 will be considered as its factor. Clear the rule for 8? Suppose a number I'll give you, suppose a number I'm giving you 5, 4, 9, you have to write its factor. Okay, so how can you say 8 is its factor? Simply, you divide 5, 4, 9 by 8. Okay, when you will divide this number, if in remainder place, you get 2 remaining, that time 8 will not be the factor. But if you get no remainder remaining, that time 8 will be its factor. Clear, no? All the 3 digits we will divide and see by 8. And if is there is no factor, I mean, no remainder is there, that time 8 also will be its factor. Clear? Then rule for 9. Rule for 9 is same as rule for 3. What was the rule for 3? We are adding the digits of the number. Similarly, 9 also, we will add its digits. In the given number, we will add its digits. When we will add the digits, na? After adding the digits, the answer which we get, that answer should be coming in the table of 9. That answer should be coming in the table of 9. That time we can say the number is divisible by 9. You got my point clear? Same example we'll take. Suppose this is 1, 5 and 6. Is 9 the factor of this given number? How can we say? Just add the digits. When you will add 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 is coming in the table of 9. No, 12 is not coming in the table of 9. That time 156 has no I mean 9 is not the factor of 156. Clear my point? So how can we say any number has 9 as its factor? For any number 9 to be its factor, we will find the sum of its digits. Simply keep in mind, we will find the sum of its digits and answer of the sum should be coming in the table of 9. Clear? Rule for 10. In the given number, if in its ones place there is 0, then without thinking any other thing, you consider 10 also as its factor. A number I'm giving you, 550. Will 10 be its factor? Yes. 542. Will 10 be its factor? No, because 2 is not 0. Any number in its ones place, if there is 0, keep in mind, any number in its ones place, if there is 0, that time 10 will be considered as its factor. Clear, na? So once again, we will start discussing from 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then in next clip, I'll tell you for 11. What was the rule for 6? A number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by both 2 and 3. Means any number will have 6 as its factor when it has 2 and 3, both the number as its factor. If it has 2 also a factor, 3 also a factor, then 6 itself will be considered as its factor. What is the rule for 8? The given number, we will divide the 3 digits, last 3 digits, 1s, 10s and 100. The 3 digit, we will divide with 8. Okay, divide with 8. No remainder is left, means 8 is the factor of that number. If remainder is left, 8 is not the factor of that number. Okay. Rule for 9, we will add the digits of the given number. 9, what is the rule? Add the digits. While adding the digits, the answer you will get, that answer should come in the table of 9. If answer is coming in the table of 9, means yes, 9 is the factor of the given number. And the rule for 10 is, if in the given number, 1's place is 0. You all know, na, 1's place, that place, if it is 0, then 10 will be considered as its factor. Clear?